Right, so now you know before adjusting the taper clearance, we have to match some timing marks, right? Because basically there are three timing marks that we have to match. We have to match the timing mark for the crankshaft sprocket, then camshaft sprocket, and again for the injector pump sprocket, because this is the point or the mark that we are going to match when considering the injector pump sprocket, because up to this point a mark over there, there is some cut like thing that is made on the injector pump sprocket, right? So this is not that cut. When I rotate that, you can see it. When considering the camshaft sprocket, this is the point that you have to match up to this level, right? So you have to match the dot that is made on the camshaft sprocket, which is here. See this dot like thing, you can see there is a dot. So this dot must get matched with this point here. For the crankshaft sprocket also, such a point is there, but we have covered that by pasting this 0 degree, you know, sticker, right? Okay, so let's rotate. Now this is the mark on the crankshaft sprocket. Okay, I will show that. Now see, this is that particular mark with the cut on the crankshaft sprocket, right? So in here we have to match that. Let's see. Now see, I'm going to rotate little by little, right? See, now see, it came closer. Now see, little by little, I'm going to match that up to the 0 degree line. Now see, almost, yeah, it went little past. Okay, doesn't matter, let's say it is matched. So anyhow, this pointer should match with the 0 degree, but it went little beyond. Okay, let's say now it is not good to turn anti-clockwise. It is really bad to turn anti-clockwise, but you have to match that, so you have to do that very carefully. Now see, this mark on the crankshaft sprocket is matched with this 0 degree, and then mark on the camshaft sprocket is matched with this point over there. See, matched. And the mark on the injector pump sprocket, see this mark or the cut on the injector pump sprocket, so that is also matched with this indicator over there. So that is the first step, right? After making this adjustment, after aligning these three marks, then we can go for the tapered adjustment, right? Because at this point onwards, the first cylinder is undergoing compression TDC, at the last step of the compression at TDC. So you can adjust the tapered adjusting for these two valves. Then inlet of the second cylinder, then exhaust of the second third cylinder, exhaust of the third cylinder, and at that time the fourth cylinder is undergoing valve overlap, right? From this point